Okay, so this video is going to show you how you can open and run your webinar, wrap session, or meeting. So again, you're going to want to log in using my login information, mcallisterkc@appstate.edu. And the password is HENRYIII8, and then login. Okay, so this will give you a list of the upcoming and past webinars. So if you are getting ready to start your wrap session, I highly recommend that you open it 30 minutes ahead of time. That gives the students a chance to kind of come in, make sure their audio's working, what their webcam's working, in case you guys want to use that. But all you do is just click start. What that does is that's going to open and connect, and it'll probably download it onto your computers, which is cool to have, because if you want to make more than one wrap session, then you don't have to keep logging in. But you're going to see this start GoToWebinar control panel.
Welcome to the webinar. You have entered as an organizer and may now speak to any other organizers or panelists on the line. When you are ready to begin the presentation, press the Start Broadcast button on the GoToWebinar control panel to allow all attendees to hear you. This system will notify you once you begin your broadcast.
Okay, so when you're ready, go ahead and click Start Broadcast.
The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Okay, so you started the broadcast. A couple things you can do. Before you actually begin, like I said, start 30, 20 minutes early, go ahead and mute yourself, because what happens is whoever logs in can hear everything. So if you're on the phone or if you're talking to yourself like I usually do, you'll hear it. So just go ahead and mute yourself, and nobody is going to see your screen until you click the Show Your Screen button. What they will see is just a generic box that says you have a rep session scheduled at this time. They actually don't see your desktop yet. So there's a couple options you have. You can click the attendees box so you can see yourself as the organizer. Actually, you'll see my name for now. But you'll also be able to see when your student or other meeting members start to come in as attendees. You have the option for the chat box, which is right here at the bottom, so you can type in, hey, we're going to start on time, or thanks for coming. Whichever you want to use the chat box for, it's right here. So when they get here, what you'll do is you can unmute yourself, you can click Show My Screen, and then they'll be able to see your desktop. So I highly recommend you just close out your mail or your calendar or anything that pops up, anything that's personal, and they'll be able to watch everything directly. So you have the option for the webcam. You can click on the webcam button. Yay, there I am. And then they can click on the webcam button and they can see you, you can see them, you can share your screen, you can change presenters. So if you want to see what your student is up to in terms of research, you can click the change presenter button. A list of names will pop up, and then of the people that are in your webinar, then you can choose their name, and then it will show up on their desktop. So it's pretty easy process. If you want to record, you just click the record button and it will save it as an MP4. You can actually put it into Camtasia and edit if you want to, or you can just send them the recording directly. So as always, if you have any questions, come and see me. Good luck and have fun.